Okay, it's time now to give you some advice. I'm gonna do that frequently. And we will start by talking about canvas. Okay, now currently I test some material, which is this one. It's a canvas on paper, tela, they call that tela. But you know, I painted over that, and it's very good. You can find that in size A4 and A3 also. And now recently I bought this one, which is it's Canva, real Canva, but in the size of A3, and frankly, it's a very, very interesting material. And you don't need to buy a canvas over a frame, and that is very, very useful. So I will let you know my feeling about that kind of material soon. Okay, but now I'm gonna start my new series of landscapes, and my advice for those works will be about my palette. Okay, as you can see, I already prepared my palette for the first layer, the blocking layer. I would like to talk to you about those colors. It's gray. Some artists, they say we don't have to use black in our painting, but you know, even Monet, which is one impressionist, the best one impressionist in France, he said before he died, he said, all my life I did not use black during all my life, and now just at the end I use black, and I think it's a fantastic color. So don't avoid to use black. Okay, but in my case I use black and white to make a mix, to make different tones of gray, because if I want desaturate color, which is the case in most of the skies, if you look at the sky outside, you will notice that it's not really blue. Okay, you have black and white, you have gray. I have those tones, four tones of gray, and I put here two tones of blue for my sky, which is I use the blue. It's cerulean blue and French ultramarine. I mix the both because I think it's nice. Okay, but that reminds me one fantastic painter, one of the best painter in France, is Dominique Ingres. That guy, he painted huge paintings, and especially from Napoleon Bonaparte. Here you have. Okay, in my palette, as I told you, I use black and white. And why I come back to that idea, it's especially because that guy, Dominique Ingres, teach to their students that you have always to use white in your color when you start your painting, even in black. Because many colors with time become transparent, and the white makes act like cement on your painting. So my advice, but is also the advice of Dominique Ingres, use white in your background painting. The blocking layer needs white. I have here my gray, I have here my yellow ochre, and I change it with the raw amber, so I have three tones of that. And every time I use those colors, I mix those colors with a gray. So that is my first layer. As you can see, that all the colors here I put, I mix them with a gray. And if you arrive at that level in the first layer, it will be very good. Okay, that is today, and look, Okay, you can already paint over that. So if you follow that advice, that would be perfect for the next layer. So never forget, you have to put gray on all the color when you start. I would like to tell you also that I work on commission. That is much more easy for me, for you. And of course, the price is cheaper because I don't take a risk, okay, to paint something, to spend time and to have something in my house that I will sell maybe, I don't know, one day. Okay, my next project now, it's a sky and the sea from Dumaguete, Philippines, Negros. So I prepare my palette already. It's a white. I made one gray here, black and white plus blue, cerulean blue. And here I mixed cerulean blue and French ultramarine. I made that with some black inside and some gray inside on after. If you want to receive some advice from my work, if you want to witness the result of that, you have to subscribe to my channel. And if you want to ask me your question, you can, of course. Okay, that's all for that video. Keep in touch. Follow me on YouTube, YouTube better, if you want to have more advice on my painting and my techniques. I let you, so don't give up. Check for information, improve your skills, and we meet soon in the next video. Thank you for following me.